Hello everyone, this is Srini Srivastava from Indore and this is my new tutorial, first tutorial that I'm going to show you. And this video is related to C++ introduction. In this video, I will tell you basic concept of C++, and for this purpose I make one PPT. So just open my PPT here. So C++ OOPS concept. What is the meaning of OOPS concept? OOPS means object oriented programming language. Okay, so first of all we understand the introduction of C++. C++ programming language developed by AT&T Bell Laboratories in 1979 by Bjarne Stoltzfus. C++ is fully based on object-oriented technology, and C++ is the successor of C language. It means all the features that C have, it also included in a C++. The extra features are already added in C++, and it is a case-sensitive language. It means lowercase is different and uppercase is different. So what is the features of C++? C++ is a middle level language. C++ support principle of object oriented paradigm, and C++ joined three separate programming traditions. The procedural language tradition represented by C, and the object oriented language tradition represented by the class enhancement C++ added to C. Generic programming supported by C++ templates. So what is the facts? Facts is that C++ OOPS aspect was inspired by a computer simulation language called Simula 67. Java is written in C++, and the major operating system is modern time or written in C++. C++ is world's fourth most used programming language. Now, comparison between C and C++. What is the difference? What is the comparison similarities between C and C++? Now, number one is C++ is a superset of C language. C++ programs can use existing C software libraries. C follows top-down approach of programming as and another way. C++ follows bottom approach of the programming. C adopts procedural oriented programming, and C++ adopts object oriented programming. History. If you are talking about history of C++, so the founder of C++ is a Bjarne Stoltzfus and developed it in 1979 at AT&T Bell Laboratories. C is a classes, C with classes, 1983, right? So now I'm talking about what is OOPS. OOPS is one of the programming approaches in which complex problem is divided into small parts so that each small part can easily handled by user. The main aim of OOPS is to reduce program complexity. In OOPS, we use class and object concepts. What is the property of OOPS? We have so many properties of OOPS, and the main property is object, class, abstraction, encapsulation, inheritance, polymorphism. So we discuss one by one what it is. Okay, so first one is object. Object, what is object? Object are primary runtime entity in an OOPS. To use any object, to use any class, its object must be created. An object is an physical instance of any class. Object is a real-time entity which exists in environment. Syntax. What is the syntax? Class name and object name. And what is the example? Telephone, book, computer, right? So this is the example. Now I'm talking about class. Class is a group of objects that share common properties and relationships, right? Class is a collection of data member and member function. Class is a user-defined data type. By default, the member of class is primary. To declare a class, we use class keyword. Now, what is the syntax of class? We write class keyword and class name, access specifier, and list of data member, access via list of member function. This is the syntax. Access specifier. Now, what is access specifier? We have three access: public, private, protected. We tell for this in the next half video, because this video become a lengthy, okay. Representation class, suppose we have a class of human, then data member is name here, color, and member function is walking, everything, okay. So this is the structure of programming oriented in C++. So here, this is the header file, this is the class name, and this is variable of fields, class members, and all the class. It is very easy to understand, right? Abstraction. What is the meaning of abstraction? Abstraction refers to act of representing essential features without including the background details. So what does it mean? So we have an example. We are applying for only the essential features to drive the car. Example, gear handling, steering handling, use of clutch, accelerator, brakes, etc. But while driving, do you get into internal details of car, like wiring, motors, what's up, etc. You just change the gear. What is happening inside is hidden from you. Right, so this is abstraction. Now, what is encapsulation? You can see with the help of picture, we have a capsule for wrapping up data and its associated function into a single unit known as encapsulation, for example, capsule. Inheritance. Inheritance is one of the most best example of the programming language. It is the process of inheriting properties and behaviors of existing class into a new class. Existing class is equal to the old class and also current class and base class. New class is also known as child class and parent class, right? Inheritance, when each object has certain kind of relationship between each object, then it is called inheritance. Inheritance is an important concept from books in which the properties of one class can be accessed by another one. And inheritance provides reusability concept. So here we have an example, we have a syntax, and we have types also. We have summary and polymorphism. The ability to take more than one form is called polymorphism. When each object performs same kind of operation, then it is called polymorphism. So this is the basic introduction of C++, and this is my first video. I know this is not an effective video, but thank you for us. Thank you.